Hi guys, my name is Shiuli and welcome to my channel. For those of you who have been here for some time now, I highly appreciate it. I thank you so much and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a topic which has a love and hate relationship with a lot of people. It's about winged eyeliners. Some people just do it on a regular basis without putting too much thought into it, and some people are extremely intimidated by it. I stand somewhere in the middle. Nor am I too good at it, neither like really bad. I'm just okay. It does the job for me. One of my best friend has been asking me to make a video on this topic for years now. So Sakshi, this is for you. And yeah, this is a two-part video. This first part is going to be with a liquid liner and a Kajal pencil, and then there'll be a part two. I won't be releasing them simultaneously, but it will be out in, like, it'll be out soon. The part two would be out soon. So yeah, without blabbering too much, let's jump straight into the video. Also, do not forget to go down and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I upload a video. Let's jump right in. If you haven't noticed, my hair looks curly. Okay, I have extremely straight, poker straight hair, but yeah, I tried to curl my hair with an overnight curling method. It, to some extent, did work, but to some extent did not. So yeah, if I'll try it once or twice more, and if it does work, I will be doing a video on this soon, so stay tuned. So yeah, let's start. So the product that I will be using today is the Lakme Absolute Shine Line. This is what I'll be using as my liquid liner for today. And for Kajal pencil, I will be using the Nykaa Rock the Line Kajal liner. This is a retractable one. You can also use a normal Kajal pencil, but I can't find my sharpener, and that is the reason why I'm not using this. Otherwise, I really wanted to use this. This is my favorite Kajal. It's jet black. It stays for the longest time, and I'm really comfortable using this, but I can't find a sharpener. Dummy. So yeah, I'll start off with the Kajal liner first, because liquid liner is something a lot of people tend to use, but Kajal is something people don't use for a winged liner. So yeah, I'm gonna start off with that first. I'm just gonna drink some Red Bull, because why not? Okay, I'm gonna move a little closer. Don't get scared. Hi. Okay, this is extremely close and this makes me very uncomfortable, but yeah, we gotta roll with it. And my cute mirror from Hong Kong is right here. Isn't it very cute? So yeah, I'm gonna use this and I'm gonna use the Kajal. So one step which is applicable in both the ways of applying eyeliner is, you should never tug your eyes like that, because it disrupts the shape of your face and you actually don't know how the liner is gonna look as an end result on your face. Do you get it? As in, this is how my face is, so I'll know how to, you know, like, okay, this is the wing, this is the angle that I should take the wing in, etc, etc. If it should be a fatter eyeliner, a thinner one, blah, 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 how long, how short. I can judge it according to how my face structure and shape and the shape of my eyes is. But when I do this, I kind of disrupt the way I look. And then, you know, I might draw something which might look good, but it won't be appropriate for my face shape. So I don't suggest doing that. I just think you should directly look into the mirror and start. Don't take out the Kajal, like, don't roll it out too much, otherwise it'll tend to break. Even when you're using the normal Kajal pencil, I would suggest that you sharpen it sharp, but not too sharp, that too sharp and too thin that it breaks when you use it. So yeah, just a little bit. Okay, and we're gonna start off at the outer corner. Okay, so I am gonna start off where my, like, this arch, okay, see, this is the line that I'm gonna follow from where my eye ends to my eyebrows. Okay, here is where the arch of my eyebrows end, so I'm just gonna draw a rough line. Do you see that? This is in line with my eyebrows, and you can decide how long or how short do you want it. The next step would be to pull it back inside. Okay, I don't recommend starting from the inside, okay, because sometimes you tend to make mistakes that way while coming outside, and it minimizes your chances of having symmetrical liners. Okay. So I just pulled it inside inwards from where I had actually drawn the wing out, and now I will connect it to the inside and fill it in. And there it is. A liner done with a Kajal liner, it won't be very sharp, okay, and it won't be very even, you know, like the one that you do with a liquid liner. It's very sharp because you can draw precise lines. With this you can't, so this is more of like a bold, like it's even bolder. It's like a gel liner, but not very precise. Usually when I do a liner with a Kajal, I like to smudge it out and make it into a smoky eyeliner over a precise one. So yeah, here it is. So let's move on to the other eye. I will be using the Lakme Absolute Shine Line here. The reason I use this eyeliner is because it says Shine Line, but it's actually 100% matte, and I love matte eyeliners. I have a very oily skin, so if I don't use a matte eyeliner, or if I use a glossy eyeliner, I tend to look like somebody who has recently deep fried some pakode, because I look very oily, okay, very greasy, and the eyeliner just complements onto the grease, like it makes me look even greasier. So I at least prefer my eyeliner to be matte if my face cannot, because that is something I cannot control. So yeah, this has been my holy grail for, I don't know, the past 5-6 years now, even more. Like from the time this has been out in the market and from the time I have discovered this, I have used, I've tried a lot of them, but this has stuck. I have not let this go like at all, because this is amazing, okay? It's very beginner friendly, to be very honest. I'll tell you why, because this has a really long, can you see, like a really long tip, and it's very thin, okay? It gives you really precise lines. It's very hard to mess up with this. You can like change the intensity of your liner very easily. You can make it very thin, you can make it very bold, whatever you wish. It's easy with this, and if you like matte eyeliners, this is it. This is not, I would not say this is very long lasting. It won't give you like 8 or 10 hours of wear, but you can easily pull through a 4 or 5 hour wear with this. After that, it doesn't go away, but then it starts looking a little dull. So yeah, it's great. It's great. You should buy this. So I'm gonna start off with the same principle that I did here, the same thing, okay? This is going to be hard. Okay, the same principle. I'm gonna draw the wing, I'm gonna join it inside, then from here, and then just fill it in, okay? Do you know there are these patches on your face that don't evenly spread product? This is that patch on my face, and I have been noticing this for such a long time. The foundation doesn't blend, the powder doesn't sit, the blush just sits over it. I don't know, I don't even know what to do with it. Anyway, ignore it, let's move on. So when you remove the wand, you just want to brush off the excess, because if you don't, you're gonna have a lot, and it's difficult to control. Like less product is easier to control. You can always add more but never get rid of it, if you know what I mean. So yeah, starting with the same principle. Do you see? This was much more precise, okay? And I'm just gonna now draw the wing inside. Did you see? I just pulled it back in, okay? You draw this and then you pull it back in. Now I will connect it from the inside and fill this in. Simple? I don't think so. No, it is. I'm just kidding. It just looks that way. You should try it on like on your own, and then you'll realize how simple this is. There you go. I love the liquid liner personally because it gives the best result, and for a wing liner, I think I prefer the liquid liner over anything else. It's quicker, it's faster, you don't need multiple tools with it. Like, I also love the gel liner, but the problem is that for a gel liner, you need like a brush separately, which I don't usually prefer, but I just push you guys a little away so that this does not make me uncomfortable. Better, isn't it? So, yep. Yeah, this is much more precise, as you can see. So yeah, as you can see, this is much more precise, and that is why I love liquid liners. It just decreases the hassle of every day. You get it? I don't usually wear liner on a daily basis, but then when I do, I always reach out for the liquid liner because it's simpler, it's faster, and even if I have to carry it in my purse, I think the liquid liner is the best. So yeah, the Kajal liner, great for occasions, great to smoke out, great to create depth and dimension, great for Indian looks because it just amps everything up because of how dark and how pigmented it is. It's very easy to smoke out, and I really love it about it. But for a multi-purpose thing, like if Indian or for a party or even for work or for college, I would always prefer the liquid liner because I can decide the intensity of what my wings should look like, and it's just faster that way. But yeah, these are the two ways that I do my eyeliner, and they're both simple, they're both great. You can choose and like whichever you want. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next. Bye guys.